Hello students, I am Dr. Nidhi Mathur and today we will be starting a new subject that is Financial Market and Services, and we will be starting with the lecture 1 for our topic, which is Overview of Microfinance and Types of Microfinance. So now, why is this important? Why microfinance is important? If we say that microfinance, what does that mean? Microfinance, microfinance is important because it is a very important aspect of financial markets. In this lecture, first I will be starting with the outline of the lecture and how we are going to proceed for the lecture. So when I come to the outline, we will start with the introduction of microfinance, then how it has evolved in our country, then what are the features of microfinance, how it differs from microcredit, then what is the need for microfinance in India, and what are the advantages for the country. So this is how we will be proceeding for our lecture of microfinance. Now, when we say that microfinance, it comes into our mind that there are two words which are into it. The first one is the micro and second one is the finance. If you all have listened carefully, what does this micro means? Micro means which is something very small, and finance is what n number of sources of funds. When we talk of finance, and as you all are specialization students of finance and you are studying it, so finance is any type of funding facility which is available to the borrowers from who has extra money. So what does this mean? Is microfinance means providing finance which is micro in nature. Now if I come to the definition which has been given by Reserve Bank of India, microfinance is an economic development tool. Make it sure, economic development tool whose objective is to assist the poor to work their way out of poverty. The first thing which is important for microfinance here is that it is used for the economic development. Theek? So main objective is the economic development. Second is to take the people out of poverty. Poverty is what? Poverty means the people who are living in poor economic conditions. Fine. How do we do it? We do with the range of services, the financial services which we are providing to them in the form of credit or savings or money transfer or insurance. So this is how RBI has defined the term microfinance. If I go deeper into it, or if I say that when we refer to it to a certain particular definition, then it comes to that microfinance refers to the provision of affordable financial services. Now, what is this provision of affordable financial service? Financial service, we all know, financial services are of various categories. They are insurance, they are money transfer, they are saving schemes, they are financing schemes. But affordable financial services are those services which can be affordable by the socially and economically poor people, and these are the disadvantaged segment. So now, up if I define this, if I define microfinance, so there are three terms which come to into our mind. The first one is the financial services which we are providing, and for what we are providing those services? We are providing these services for the economic development. This is not that we have set up microfinance institutions for earning money. The microfinance institutions are set up for providing them economic development. By to whom? To the socially and economically poor people. Now this comes as socially and economically poor people. That means that we want to uplift those people, and it is very well clear in this definition that yes, we want to alleviate them from poverty. Fine. So now it would be very clear to you all that microfinance is to provide the poor people or the economically backward people or the socially backward people finances on affordable prices, so that their standard of living is improved. And how does the standard of living is improved? The standard of living is improved by the increase in the income level. When the income level of the people has increased, naturally their standard of living is increased. If I clearly say ki when we talk about ourselves, if I say about myself or yourself, we'd say during the period when the income level of the country has increased or the income level of the citizens of the country has increased, the naturally the standard of living has increased. So the microfinance is established. Why this microfinance term has come out? The microfinance term has come out for the development of the poor people who are socially and economically backward. How does it has come? Fine. If I go back after Bangladesh was formed, Muhammad Yunus of Bangladesh. He was a pioneer into this. He was a pioneer into establishing the Grameen Bank. Now we all have it. Now Grameen Bank has become a common term in the country, but it was pioneered by Muhammad Yunus, and he has got the Nobel Peace Prize for that. What he has done is to alleviate the Bang. We all know that Bangladesh is a socially and economically backward country, and to alleviate the people from poverty, he has come up with the concept of Grameen Bank, and this was the main starting, or I say the evolution of the microfinance concept from Grameen Bank. Later on in our lecture number 4 and 5, we will be discussing how this model has worked on. Now for the time being, we are discussing it for the reason we will be later on taking it. Fine. Now Muhammad Yunus in 1974, he has come up with this, and he had got in 2006, he had got a Nobel Prize for this. Fine. And this concept is very much applicable. This model is in fact very much applicable in our country also. In India, if I talk about India, in India, who was the pioneer? SIDBI was the pioneer. What is SIDBI? SIDBI is the Small Industrial Development Bank of India. In 1989, what happened was, there was an act was passed to develop these small industries. Someone has very clearly said that the India is where? India is in the villages of the country, and India is in the rural villages, and we have a number of small industries. Nowadays, when our GDP has grown up, or we can say that when the economy is growing up, in this time we can say that okay, we have large industries, but there was a time when we didn't have the large industries. So it was felt that there should be some bank or some institution who would be helping those industries. Industries in what? Industries in providing finances, industry to provide training to them. And for keeping in mind that objective, the SIDBI has come up with the act, and SIDBI was formed to help the self-help groups who are formed to help each other. Fine. Self-help groups are what? We have actually already heard about those self-help groups or joint liability, but we are not very much clear. So when we will be coming to the different types of microfinance institution, we will be discussing the self-help group and how they are evolved. After that, SIDBI has come a bank, that is National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, was formed in 1992. The objective of the bank was to provide loan to the farmers for the agriculture and the rural purposes. Those agriculture and rural purposes, why do they need assistance? If we say the condition of farmers, if we say the condition of farmer was worst than today, and they need money for small finances at a low price because they were not able to pay the interest rates which were levied by the other institution. Even they want the officers who can understand them, who can understand what are the facilities which are provided to them. So in that case NABARD was established to help those agricultural institution. And in 2006, NABARD has also launched enterprise development program, where they were developing the skills of the people also. What are these skills? Why do we need to develop the skills of the people? The skills of the people are to be developed because we have people who want livelihood, but for earning a livelihood we also need certain skills, and for skill development we would be needing certain trainings, and NABARD has come up with that. After that, the country never looked back. We have n number of microfinance institutions. Even now we have set up indexes for microfinance institutions, and we have come up with the IPOs also. What are those IPOs? IPOs are the, you are finance students and you all would be knowing that IPOs are initial public offering. Fine. And these IPOs were also launched for the microfinance or the small industries. In this way we have evolved into microfinance, and now we can say that the microfinance institution has a very large portion of investment in the country, and they are developing also. And if I say in the recent times, where entrepreneurship is promoted or entrepreneurship is encouraged, these micro enterprises or the micro finance institutions, they are flourishing in our country, and this is how we have evolved into microfinance. You all are being taught this subject because of the reason that tomorrow that you have taken finance and you would be going to for some companies or you would be setting up your own businesses. So being an entrepreneur, it is very much important that you should be aware of what are the facilities of microfinance, how we can get those microfinance. This is why you need this, and that is why this subject is taught to you. And it is also very important. When the term finance comes, now we have that habit of taking it as, okay, it is about all about money, and we are giving money to some people and we are generating income, because it is taught to us that what is finance is, finance is generating the income. But it is not that. When we talk about microfinance, there are specific features of microfinance which we all need to discuss and we which all need to know also. Fine. So the first one, which is important, is the borrowers are low income groups, which I have very, very clearly explained and told you in the definition also. Ki when it comes to microfinance, it is what it is, the funds which are available for the low income group, means the borrowers or the people who are taking that microfinance are the low income group people. Fine. The second one, they are of small amounts. We cannot say that we are giving loans of 10 crores or 20 crores to people. No, they start from 50,000, they start from 20,000 to a certain level. Fine. The microfinance is for the small amounts, so that the lower income people can repay that amount. Fine. The third thing, which is the most important and which I think is very, very important when we say microfinance and how does it differ from the other financial services, it is without collateral. Now, what are collaterals? If I say collateral means something guarantee we are keeping. You all know that we go for bank finance, and everyone has gone to the bank also. You all would be knowing that we have auto finance, we have house finance. For every asset, for every loan, we have to keep certain collateral as asset. And if I keep certain collateral as asset, that means I should have that asset. But when I talk about this low income group, they don't have anything to keep it as collateral. In that case, what we need is that we have to give them loan without any collateral, and this makes it different from other finances. Fine. Make sure that whenever a difference is asked to you, that how does the normal finance, it is not the amount which is differing, it is what, it is the without collateral. The fourth important aspect, that is, it is meant for, generally taken for income generating. I am not saying, I have noted here the term generally. What does this generally means is ki when the people are asking for microfinance or they are applying for the microfinance, it is for income generating activities. But keep in mind, it is not always for the income generating activities. It may be for the consumption also, for the marriage of their daughter, or if they want to build their houses, or they can be for different purposes. They want it for the treatment as well, they want to start a small plant, they want something for the household work. So we can say this, that the microfinance is for the income generating activities, but it is not always for the income generating activities, but generally it is for that. Okay. Another important aspect is the tenure of the loan is short. It is not like our home loans and all, that it will extend to 10 years or 50 years, because these people, they are low income group. They cannot go for any such type of liability where they are engaged for a number of years. So they want the loans of shorter period. And the very important aspect is the repayment, the frequency of repayment is very much large. It means that when we go for auto finance, when we go for home finance, what we have EMIs. And what are those EMIs? EMIs are monthly installment. But for microfinance, the frequency of repayment is large. It can be a week, it can be a fortnight, it can be monthly also. Because see, what is the reason for it? The reason for it is that when a lower income group person go for a finance, okay, he has gone and he is going for income generating activity. He will be generating the income every day, every month, every week. it may happen that he cannot plan for the finances and he would not be able to repay it. To make it comfortable for those people to repay that loan, what they have done is they have increased the frequency that yes, you can pay your loans in a high frequency and you can pay it fortnightly so that they should not have pressure or liability later on. Fine. So these are the features of microfinance. Whenever you explain the term microfinance, it is important that after giving the definition, you have to give the features also. Whenever we are introducing the concept of microfinance, it is important that the features and the introduction should be given properly so that the person who is your listening you or who knows you, he must understand what are the basics of microfinance. Fine. Often it happens that this term is confused with a term which is known as microcredit. What does credit means? Credit means borrowing. And even if I say microfinance, I have also given the term microfinance that it is also a type of borrowing. But now we have to say the difference, or we have to differentiate them. When we differentiate them, then microcredit is a smaller term. Rather, I should say that when we borrow something which is smaller in amount or which has some collateral, or sometimes it also does not have any collateral, fine. So when we have something we borrow without collateral or with little collateral, fine, by registered institutions, if it is a registered institutions, then it is termed as microcredit. And sometimes it also happens when the salaried people, they are also asking for smaller loans, it is also termed as microcredit. Now you got my point. What is the difference between microcredit and microfinance? The difference point is that it is not important that it should be legally registered institution, first thing, which is very, very important. The second thing is also that we say which is something which is smaller in nature, something which is lesser in amount, we take it as micro. But when it comes to microfinance, it is a broader term. It does not only includes your money or the credit, but it also include your small savings, insurance, money transfer of poor. Fine. And here one more thing which is very important is their objective. The objective of your microcredit is to give credit to somebody and to generate the income. But when I say about microfinance, when I say microfinance term, it is generating income and alleviating the poverty. That means we are also focusing upon the social and economic upliftment of a particular class of people or particular gender, or I may say a particular group. Here I may be very clear that sometimes when microfinance is considered, they are also gender based. Fine. In the later on classes, we will be knowing how this is helpful, how microfinance is helpful for the gender upliftment also, for gender equality also. So whenever we have to differentiate between the microcredit and microfinance, it is important for us to know that microcredit is a smaller term which includes only providing credit to some people. But when I say it is microfinance, it is a broader term which includes your savings, your insurance, money transfers, and any other facility which we are providing for the economic and social upliftment of a particular income group, or I can say it may be a lower income group also. Now coming in India, why do we need microfinance? Why it has come up? Now you can see, you people would be saying, or it has come to in your mind, there are a number of financial institutions and they are providing all types of loans, they are providing all type of financial services. We have now e-services for funds, we can say we have private banks also. If I say Airtel Bank is there, so why do I need this? Why do I need microfinance in our country? Fine. Why this has come up in our country? The first important thing which is here is the banks have been more or less hesitant. To whom? To the poor people. The poor people, or those who are needy, these people are always facing problems in getting the loans. Why? Because the banks, they know they know that they cannot manage their account because they know the borrowers are poor. It would be difficult for them to repay the loans. Every time they would have to go to them, every time they would have to ask them for some collaterals and all. So banks were always hesitant into it. Secondly, the poor people have no or few assets to offer as collateral. I have already said, and I was always saying this to you, that the poor people, they have an issue that they don't have collateral. If you go back to rural India, I don't know how many of you have this rural background, but if you go back to rural India, the problem which they face, what is the problem they face is they don't have any collateral. They all want a livelihood, they all have a plan, they can all want income generating activities, but the real issue is what? The real issue is that they don't have any collateral with them, and in that, for that time, we want an institution, we want an organization which could help those people, which could help these economically backward people to generate funds or to get funds. And because, and why do the banks do not provide? Because banks were not, if we talk about non-performing assets or NPA, what are NPAs? What are non-performing assets? Non-performing assets are the defaulters of the bank, fine. And if I say the newspapers, you are daily reading the newspapers, you are daily coming across the news that the banks' NPAs are increasing, and this is the fear of the banks right now also, that when they are giving to the people who don't have any collateral, how will they repay the loan? If you say that I go for a home loan and I am not able to pay my EMIs, in that case, what is going to happen? The bank is going to seize my home, fine, because it has a collateral. But for the poor people, for the person who are backward, they don't have any collateral with them. And when they don't have any collateral with them, it becomes difficult for them to repay their loans, fine. The third important thing is that the majority of the people who are backward, they don't even have certain saving accounts in the bank. All of you may have come across a term, financial inclusion, right now. Okay? What is that financial inclusion? In India, it has, I am saying, it's a buzz around financial inclusion, and everywhere you will find the people, they are saying, okay, the government is working on financial inclusion. What does that financial inclusion actually means? Financial inclusion means including all the people into the financial system. If I say in the Indian economy, where there are n number of people who still don't have bank accounts, fine, and when they don't have the bank accounts, the saving bank accounts, so how could they avail any financial service? And for those people, we need certain institution, we need certain facilities to facilitate them to come into the mainstream of the banking system and come across in the main economy, to make them economically practically feasible in the economy, fine, or make them stable in the economy, make them a part of the economy. The fourth important is, we say financial literacy. What is that financial literacy? Financial literacy is, if I have knowledge about all the services which are provided to me, how much, what will be the forms to be filled, which ID proof I require for it, and this lack of knowledge is another reason why the people are not getting credit from the banks. Think of a farmer who wants certain finance it for the seeds, he wants certain good quality of seeds and he doesn't have fund. You always want that my crop should be better than the last year, but he doesn't have those funds. In that case, what he is going to do? Because when he is not aware of the services which are provided by the government, he is not able to get certain finances. And this was also a reason ki we need a specific institution which should work for these people and make them to carry out their economic activity, because these people, they have their ideas, they have their own problems, but they don't have that literacy that they can discuss it or they can get out of it. For those reason, they need certain institutions which are specified for their purposes, fine. Microfinance was also required for the economic transformation. When our rural and our small industries grow, naturally our country will also grow. nowadays we are also coming up with a new, rather I should say, slogan, that is Atmanirbhar Bharat. What does it focuses upon? It focuses upon our own industry and how these industry will grow up. And we know that India has a mixture of industries which are macro industries as well as micro industries, and these industries and the need for finances is also different for these industries. The next important is the need for microfinance to meet the life cycle needs. What are the life cycle needs? As the people grow on and their life cycle comes, they need certain things, and which, see, when the child is born, there are certain needs. When he grows up, there are education needs. When he is adult, for the jobs and then for the marriage and all. So these needs are termed as life cycle needs, and for every small needs, these microfinance institution helps the poor people. So finally, I can say in the end that we need microfinance for two reasons, that is economic and social upliftment. For whom? For people. And the last, I have also said earlier that it is for also women empowerment. If I say the craftsmen, if I say the people who are of rural background, many industries are run by women in India. If I say about the small industries, the cottage industries, maximum industries are run by the women. And to empower those women, these microfinance institutions play a very important role. What are the different types of microfinance companies which are operating in India? Okay, I have told you that I will be discussing this in the later on lecture, and the first one is the joint liability group, the second is self-help group, the third is the Grameen Bank model, and fourth one is rural cooperatives. The joint liability groups are what? The joint liability groups are those groups who are formed, formally these groups are formed, and they take their responsibility. Okay, give us finance and we all will be responsible to pay it back. That is joint liability group. Sometimes it is confused with the term which is self-help group. So self-help group is very much different from this joint liability group because of the reason. Self-help group is what? Say for example, there are 10 to 20 ladies and they all want to establish their own cottage industry. In that case, when they are establishing their cottage industry, someone has the saving, but the other one has the idea. So what they do is they collect certain funds from those who had extra funds with them, and they help some other people. And every time when they do is they are financing the other. Fine, they are financing the other, and this is how the self-help group and work in India. I must say that I am very proud to say that these self-help groups have worked so hard, and they can be in the terms of NGOs also. The NGOs have also worked like self-help group, or I can say NGO has also established these self-help groups. Fine. The third one is the Grameen Bank model, which is what the banks which are established to facilitate the agriculture industry or the farmers, and these farmers are the backbone of our economy, and they provide loans at a lower interest rate, the fixed deposits and savings and other schemes to whom? To the farmers. What are rural cooperatives? Rural cooperatives, we know what are cooperatives. Cooperatives are certain organizations which are legally formed to serve a particular purpose, where all the members they cooperate with each other for a particular goal they are established. So if I say Amul is also a cooperative, hai na? And why it was established? For the rural women of the country. Fine, this is how in India this goes. Now we will coming up to the benefits of microfinance. Fine. So the first one, which we have made it very very clear, is it provides finance to the poor people for carrying out their economic activities. Make sure the economic activity is important. Second, it provides employment to the poor people. So the first one is for the economic activity, second is for the employment, and third one is what? It also provide them with insurance and cover their risk. The fourth one is gender equality or equity for women empowerment. So there are four things which will come up. The first one is the economic activities, second one is employment, third one is risk coverage, and fourth one is women empowerment. Now when I will be summarizing this, so we have covered up a brief background about microfinance, how microfinance has grown up in India, how it has evolved during the time, why do we need microfinance and what is the importance or the benefits of microfinance. So I think it may be clear to you all a basic introduction about microfinance and how it goes on. Fine. In the next lecture, we would be starting with this income generating activities, which I have shown in these slides and which is a basis for the microfinance, because we all know that it is the pillar of microfinance. Thank you.